For some, this time of year brings concerns about making Christmas too secular. There was a time when the holiday was actually banned in parts of the U.S. The first war on Christmas came from an unlikely source. Historian Kenneth C. Davis is the author of the Don't Know Much series of history books. He joins us this morning. Good morning and Merry Christmas Eve.
Merry Christmas Eve to you both.
It's Can we first say spectacular Christmas vest?
Well, thank you.
You dressed the part.
Very festive today, as we all should be.
So the first war on Christmas, if you will, was hundreds of years old, right?
It's true. And this goes back to the beginnings of American history, the pilgrims. We think of the pilgrims coming here and beginning American traditions. Well, one of the traditions they began was banning Christmas. They did not allow Christmas festivities. Why? Well, they were a festive bunch. They loved to celebrate. No, actually, they thought their idea of Christmas was you go to church and pray for 3 hours and be told you were going to burn in hell. But the real reason, and this goes back to the roots of Christmas, is they thought it was too Catholic. These were Protestants, and Christmas was a very, what they would have called, popish holiday. And that continued for a long time in America. Christmas does not become a federal holiday in America until 1870.
So when did the modern version of Christmas, how we celebrate it, emerge?
It really begins in the early 19th century, and two literary events are really important. A Night Before Christmas is published in 1823. It really introduces the idea of Santa Claus as we know him. This is by Clement Clark Moore. And it's significant that that's in New York. That was a German-Dutch colony, and so all of those traditions were allowed. Christmas is celebrated in different ways in different parts of early America. And a little bit later on, of course, 1843, Charles Dickens writes A Christmas Carol, and it's really then cemented that Christmas is this family event. Before that, it was really a kind of an event, a holiday, where there was a lot of riotous drinking early on in American history, kind of like SantaCon, if you're a New Yorker and you know. That happened a long, long time ago. There was actually a riot in 1806 called the Christmas Riot in New York City.
Vanita was trying to introduce that in studio this morning just before the broadcast, and we nixed that. The modern version of Santa Claus that we know, how did he come to be and what he looks like?
Well, like a lot of things about Christmas that we love and cherish today, it goes back to a very ancient tradition before Christianity. There was a Norse god named Odin who rode across the night sky on an eight-legged horse. And that really became the beginnings of the Father Christmas idea that got merged together with this character named Saint Nicholas. The Dutch called Saint Nicholas Sinterklaas, and when they bring him to New York, that eventually becomes changed into the English Santa Claus. So a Norse god, an old Christian bishop from long, long ago, and the Dutch all come together. And that's American Christmas. We bring together all these different traditions from many immigrant traditions, many immigrant countries, and they all get kind of merged together when they get to America.
When you look back historically, though, is there a point in time when people say this is where it switched over to a holiday based on gifts? Because I feel like so much of it now is really just about getting stuff.
Well, it was a gift-giving holiday from the very beginning, partly because of the image of Saint Nicholas, this early Christian saint, being a generous spirit who gave gold coins to young women who were very poor. He actually threw them through the window, which is how the idea of the gifts coming down the chimney actually comes into play. So that's a very, very old idea. Saint Nicholas was celebrated on December 6th. That was his feast day. And so gradually that December date gets connected to gift giving into Christmas. And it's really a much more recent tradition in terms of the big boxes on Sunday on Christmas morning that we think about. That's a 19th century thing. As I mentioned, Christmas doesn't become a federal holiday until 1870. That was because they wanted to bring the North and the South together after the Civil War. So they used this date, this day of Christmas, as a sort of American holiday that we could all share.
Well, Ken Davis, we thank you for joining
us
on Christmas Eve.
My pleasure. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And to all a good night.